GNAT Project Manager, Part 2, Development Strategy and Overview. Here's a diagram of the architecture that is used to facilitate the development strategy presented in this tutorial. W, R, and V are logical disk drives mapped to the workspace, release, and version directories, respectively. These directories represent the state of the software system at any given time for a specific version of a specific subsystem. The release drive is read-only and serves as a baseline for further development. An incremental release is produced at regular intervals, such as one per week. Since a workspace is derived from the release, the contents of the release project is used to enforce project-wide standards regarding quality and style, code formatting, test coverage, tool switches, compiler directives, and so on, for the development, test, and production environments, each of which has different requirements. The release project is configured to enable a selection of modules and components via a drop-down menu. The source filters associated with the modules and components in the release are artifacts of the development environment, which are maintained by the version control system on drive V. At the end of a development cycle, each developer commits the code in his or her workspace to version control. The release and configuration manager then integrates all changes into a consistent build and generates the module and component filters from the updated code base by running the script that invokes various GNAT tools. It is important to realize that the source filters only apply to code in the release view. These filters are made available to each workspace via the inheritance relationship. Because a workspace inherits its properties from the release, it can be small and simple. This arrangement frees developers from having to understand low-level project file details. Only two or three people in a large project need to have this specialized knowledge. Once a workspace project is loaded into GPS and a filter selected, the developer obtains visibility to the associated units in the release. If a unit in the release needs to be changed, then it must be transferred to the workspace, where it will reappear as a unit under version control and can therefore be checked out and modified. The GNAT Project Manager takes care of the transfer and visibility details. The various outputs produced by the compilation system appear in the workspace directories build, exec, and codepeer. Each workspace should have a source directory to serve as an area in which to either experiment or get around an issue which is blocking progress. The source directory allows us to hide units that exist on the release and version drives. I will illustrate use of this feature later in the tutorial. You might be thinking, why bother hiding an existing unit? Well, for starters, the release is read-only. Of course, you could transfer the unit to the workspace, check it out of version control, and make your changes. However, even if you have the authorization to check the unit out, reserved or unreserved, so as to temporarily get around an issue, or make some quick changes to analyze a problem, or experiment with a new algorithm, doing so will create unwanted tracks in the change management system, which creates the potential for making a technical and/or bureaucratic mess when you attempt to undo the changes. Hence, in some cases, the most efficient way to proceed is to simply copy the units or unit to the source directory in the workspace and work from there. When you're finished, just remove the files from the workspace view. As mentioned previously, the GNAT Project Manager, which interprets project files, is located between the toolchain and the source code. The project file forms a basis for all development activities at the code level, and therefore, it is very important that selected members of the team receive training in order to understand the features, possibilities, and limitations of this technology. In that case, let's begin. A GNAT project file can specify one of six qualifiers in order to indicate the rules that apply to the contents. These rules will be enforced by the project manager. If a qualifier is not specified, the project manager will use the context to determine the qualifier that applies. Project files contain information in the form of variables, attributes, and control mechanisms. There are two kinds of attributes, simple and indexed. The index can specify, for example, a programming language, or a given unit for fine-grained control of switch settings. We will see examples later on. Several GNAT tools are able to accept a project file as an input parameter. For developers, the most important tool is GPS, the GNAT Programming Studio, which integrates all the tools into one place. At the right of the diagram, I've listed some typical properties that one can specify in a project file. For example, the development environment must be set up to support your strategy, that is, the way you intend to attack the problem, where the inputs are, where the outputs go, the switches that apply to each tool, the source code format to use, the quality and style rules, static analysis details, and the list goes on. It requires a bit of work and experimentation to get it right, but when it's finally done, it'll lay the foundation for an efficient development environment. This is the end of part 2.